Well, I think it's very important. I think if you think of Amazon, people used to complain that it was simply generating revenues but never would generate any profits. Now it's turned around and they're generating profits, but people are saying the revenues are too low. So I think people have to sort of get their story straight on that. I think what you see is that it's a franchise that's delivering on all counts. AWS is on fire, and it's a much more profitable business. If you look at the numbers, then AWS is double the size of Azure at Microsoft or the business at Google, but they're all growing at 50% plus rates because I think we're at an inflection point for cloud computing. So I think it bodes very well going forward. I think if you look at the revenues on the e-commerce side, then yes, they were a percent or so lower than people were expecting, but they're still growing at rates of 30% plus. The third-party business is growing more, and there's a lot of categories that they're moving into where they still have the opportunity to grow both revenues and, importantly, profits. So we think it's an important set of numbers, but that one that really confirms the ability of the business to generate revenues and profits going forward.
And Christopher, just on the performance of AWS, given that this is such a profit driver here, I mean, you point out the recent results we had from Microsoft were quite strong there as well, but it seems to me there's nothing really denting AWS's dominance in this field.
No, we think that we see it the same way. If you look at governments and business, then they're moving to AWS because of the quality, because of the safety, and because of the reinvestment that they do. And I think that's a really important point to look at this, going back to the point we're making earlier on Facebook as well, which is we are investing alongside these founders. And if Jeff Bezos has done one thing, he's been very clear about the investments that he makes in the business and about the profits that he's expecting it to generate over time. I think with the AWS franchise, he's built an unbelievable company that analysts and investors, as recently as a year or two, didn't appreciate. Now you see where the stock is. You see it's up 50% year to date. With the move we've seen this morning, it's likely to go back to its all-time highs. It may even exceed them this morning. So I think it's a vote of confidence. And we are long-term investors in these stocks. So we are looking ahead 5, 10, and 25 years and think they have a lot of value still to generate.
So just for clarity for our audience, Amazon, Facebook, and why don't we throw Alphabet in there as well? You own all of these stocks.
Yes, we're long-term holders in all of these because we think digital transformation is just at the beginning of impacting business and the companies that dominate. And if we can find businesses that have strong positions in their franchises, like in particular Amazon and its e-commerce, but also in AWS, like Google in search and the areas it's in, or Facebook in social media, not just with the Blue app, but with Instagram and WhatsApp that are at the cutting edge of what's going on and that are just at the beginning of being monetized, then we think we have investments here that can deliver over the long term.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.